So this is some transaction level data. This is some sales order data. So for a product, how many transactions were made? How many orders were made? What was the order quantity for that product? What is the unit price of that product? And what was the total sum of that, of the value for the sales? For the total sales order, what was the total amount? So we have this kind of data. So basically, we have an order or a transaction that took place. For that transaction, for this product, how many quantity of this product was ordered? So the quantity is 3 for this product ID. The unit price for this product is whatever is the unit price. And this is simply a unit price into the quantity is your line total. So this was the total amount that was paid for this particular order for this product. So this is our input data, let's assume. And what we want in the output is something like this. So we want a report that is on the level that groups by the product. But now I just had the product ID in my source data. I want the product name. And this is my product name. I want to find out for that product, what was the total sales that happened. So I want to find out the total sum of the line total. Then I want to find out how many orders were made for that, how many transactions took place for that particular product. So I have to give a count of the transactions that took place. And then because every transaction can have multiple quantities or multiple quantities for that item or for that product, what was the maximum quantity that was ordered in any unique order ID for any product? What was the maximum quantity that was ordered in a single sales order? So this is a report that I am looking at. So the first thing is that I am calculating a lot of aggregation or summary columns, and all of them are based on the product. So my group by key here obviously is the product column. So the product ID that I am getting from the source, that would be my group by column. And all these are my output columns. So I need to perform some kind of aggregation for calculating the total sales amount for a product. I just need to sum up the line total that I saw. So I had orders and I had products mapped to them and the quantity that was paid for that order. So I just need to sum up, grouping by on the product ID, just need to sum up that sum value. Then the maximum quantity. So for each order or each product, what was the maximum? So I need to find the maximum of the order quantity. For each product, what is the maximum quantity of that product that was ordered in a single transaction order? And then how many transaction orders were made for that product? So this is my report that I am expecting in the end. So now how can we design this job? So let's go to the Data Sage Designer and try to design this job. So I already have the sources. I have configured the sequential file stages to map to those source files. So this is my sales order file or my source file, which has the details about the orders, the transaction orders, and the quantities and the line total amount. Now in my input file, I just had the product ID, and in my output report, I need the product name. So the very first step for me is to perform a lookup, because I'm just mapping the product ID to the product name. So there would be just a limited set of products, so I can go for a lookup. So here I do not need to go for a join, I can just go for a lookup. So I'll go to the processing category, and I can select the lookup stage from here. So this is my input link, and any other link that I join after the input link to the lookup stage will get converted to a reference link. Now let me take an output out of the lookup stage and configure the lookup stage. So in the lookup stage, I want to perform a simple join based on the product ID. So I'll just drag and drop and this is already performed there. This is the product ID. So the product ID is now joined to the product ID from the reference link. What is my condition? Let me just take it as drop. So any of the input record that does not find a match for the product ID, we are just dropping that record. So lookup failure condition would be drop. That is like we are trying to do an inner join. Now whatever columns I want in the output from this stage, I can just drag and drop those columns. So columns, let me take all the columns here. And from the reference link, I want the product name. So let me just drag and drop the product name column. Now this name is a little ambiguous, so we'll just rename it as product underscore name. So now this is our product name column. The next step is, now we have the product name. Now we want to calculate all those, we want to perform all those aggregations. So what I need is the aggregator stage. So now in aggregator stage, I want to, in my output report, I want to count, I want to perform a count as well. I want to perform some calculation operations. So an aggregator can either be set to count or to, for the calculation. The aggregation type can be set to either count rows or the calculation type. We cannot perform both the kinds. We cannot count at the same time and perform some calculations in the same aggregator. So to perform any of those kind of functions, we need to split the data. We need to actually have two aggregators in place. So let's pull another aggregator as well. And now I want to map this input link data in across multiple output links. So what is the stage that I should go for? The stage that will simply do this function without adding any extra overhead is the copy stage. So I'll drag and drop a copy stage here. And I'll take one output link out from copy stage, connect it to one aggregator. I'll take another output link out of the copy stage and connect it to another aggregator. So let me just drag and drop output links from the aggregators as well. Now in the copy stage, let me go to the output link. Now this is DSLink 46, which is the first aggregator. So whatever columns I need for the calculations to be performed in the first aggregator, I'll just take those columns. So first is the product ID, because that is a group by column, that is a key column. So that is needed. So we'll take that column. The other column that I need is the line total column, because I want to calculate the sum. I want to calculate the total amount for a particular product. So I want to sum up the line total. So I'll have this line total column dragged as well to the output link. The other I want to find the maximum order quantity for a particular product in a single transaction order. So I'll drag this column as well. So these are the only columns I need. I do not need the unit price column. I do not need the product name column. I need it in the final report, but I'll not take it to this link. I'll tell you why later. So let's go to the other link. In the other link, we want to perform a count rows function. So again, the key column is product ID. So we just have the product ID, and every order transaction or every sales order in the data that we received is a unique order ID. So I just need to perform the number of records. Number of records coming in from my source data for a particular product ID. And that will give me the count of orders that I got for a particular product. So I do not need to map any other column to perform the count. I just need to know my key column to perform the count. We'll say okay. Now let's go to the first aggregator. Double click on it. What is my group by key? My group by key is the product ID. So I'll have the product ID defined here. What is the aggregation type we want to perform? Calculation. What is my column for calculation? So if I click here, I'll see all the input columns that are available for this stage. So I have the line total, I have the order quantity, I have the product ID. So I want to find the total amount, so I want to sum the line total column. So I'll just select that column. then I have additional properties to add. Now I have to define what kind of operation do I want to perform on this input column. So I want to take out a sum. So I'll just look at all the operations that are available, and there's this operation called the sum output column. So I just need to select that sum output column. And here I need to specify a name for the output column. So let's just say it is total amount. So this is my sum output column. Now by default, it will either be double or float. So I do not want it to be in that data type. I want to specify it as a decimal. So let me specify some big value. So 2010. So this is basically the precision and the scale of the decimal. Now I want to perform another calculation. So I again need to click on the aggregation. I can go and add another column for calculation, because this operation I want to perform on another input column. So again, I can just click here. I'll see the list of all the input columns which are available. I'll select order quantity. Now again, I need to specify what kind of operation I want to perform on this input column. I want to find the maximum value output column. I want to find the maximum quantity that was ordered in a single transaction. So maximum value. Again, I need to define a column for this, column name for this. Maximum order quantity. And decimal output. So quantity cannot be in decimal. So I'll just define, but because this can only output in a decimal format, so I'll define something like 10, 0, because there won't be any digits after the decimal. So now we have defined a group by key, the column on which we are going to group by. We have defined the we have defined the kind of calculations that we are going to perform. The method, we leave it as hash. So what is the next step I need to do? If I go to the output tab, I'll find all these columns are available to me. Product ID, which was a column through which we grouped by. Then this is these are the output columns that we created after performing the calculations on the input columns. So we can just drag and drop them to the output as well. Now, since this is a group by operation, we have to, this is a key based operation, so we have to do a partitioning. So we can just go here, define the partitioning as hash. And what do we need to partition on? On the key column, on the group by column. So product ID and perform a sort. And say okay. Now let's move on to the next aggregator. So again, double click on it. What is my group by key column? Product ID. What is my aggregation type? Count the rows. So this is just one dependent property, count output column. So I need to give a name for this. So this is count of orders. Now this is additional property. So this is a waiting column. Instead of doing a count like 1, 2, 3, 4, you can define some increment value. So it can be, if you define 2, it will be like 1, 3, 5. In that way also it can count. Again, go to the input, do a hash partitioning, form a sort, and select your key column. Go to the output, just drag and drop. So now we have defined the aggregations that we needed to perform for our report. We have two aggregators in our job now. But now we have two different output flows coming out, and we need to combine them together into a single output flow. So for that, again, so now in this case, we should go for a join. We can go for a join. So we'll take a join. We'll just connect it to all these output links from the aggregator stages. So again take an output out from the join stage. So now if I click on the join, so I just need to define the key on which I want to join, because I perform both my aggregations on the product ID column. So that is the key I want to use to join the data together. So I select that column, product ID. The join type is inner, because it will be grouping by the product ID column. So the same number of groups should be created in both the cases for both the aggregators. So we will keep it as inner, because ideally every record should be find a match in the output from the other aggregator as well. Again, we have to define for a join, it's very important to define the partitioning and sorting on the column on which we are going to perform the join. Now, a join has two input links or more than two input links. So we have to be careful. We have to define the partitioning for each input link. Again, hash product ID perform sort. Go to the output. So now we have all the columns. We have the maximum order, total amount, count order, the product ID. Just drag and drop all the columns to the output. Now there was one more column that we needed in the report. We did not need the product ID, we needed the product name. So that column we have not propagated anywhere. So if we try to take it through this link, the first aggregator, we'll either have to include it in the group by key column. So that is our only option. We'll have to do a group by on that key column. So ideally a product ID will map to only one product name. So that should be okay. That will work fine for us. But in cases that we are doing, for example, if let's say it's a dimension and we are trying to join on some ID values, but the description, some business key value, but some of the attribute value might not be constant for all the records for the same business key value. So that is a dimension because it retains history. So in cases of data warehousing, we'll not be able to map all the other columns on which we are not performing any aggregation functions directly through the aggregator. Because an aggregator, like a group by clause in a SQL, you cannot have columns on which you are either not performing an aggregation function or you are not using in the group by clause. So for all those columns, what we would need to do is we'll need to take them through an alternate path. So I need to define one more link, input link for the join. So again, let's use a copy stage. So this copy stage doesn't have any function. I'm just using it so that I can create the links properly. They look proper. The diagram looks proper. Otherwise, it has no use. And we can use as many copy stages because it doesn't cause any performance overhead. So copy stage can be used. So if I have not mapped the output to this copy link, so I just need the product ID column, the key on which I want to perform the join, and the product name column. Now what will actually happen is when we run this job, the output will pass, will come till here, all the input records, let's say there are 100 records coming in, 100 records will come till here. Aggregation will happen. Let's say there are 10 distinct groups that get formed. So after the aggregator stage, there will be 10 records on this thing. There will be 10 records on this thing. But coming from the copy stage, there will still be 100 records, because that would retain the same number of records as came from the input. Coming from here, again, there would be 100 records joining into the join stage. So 10 records from here, 10 records from here, 100 records from here would still result in 100 records. Whereas we do not want all the input records to go to the output, we just want the aggregated records to go to the output. So what we can do here is, we can use another stage. So instead of using a copy here, just delete it. And there's another stage called the remove duplicate stage. Now in the remove duplicate stage, we can again define a key column and just select unique records for that. We can remove all the duplicates. It will randomly select a unique record for that key column. So duplicates to drain first or last, we can give two options here. So again, because it is a key based operation, you have to give a partitioning hash. Again, we are removing duplicates on the product ID column. Go to output and just drag and drop. So now for my join stage, I'm again doing an inner join. If I go to link ordering, because join stage can have more than one input link, so it will specify, it will indicate that one link is the left link, one link is the right link, the other, all the other extra links would be known as intermediate links. So again, I need to do partitioning for all the input links. So for the new input link that I have here, you need to define the partitioning as hash and the product name is here. Now I can just map it to the output. So let's just write it to a data set now, all this data. And define a dataset name. So let's look in if we have any job parameter. We have the file path, and I've already defined a parameter for the dataset name. So let's just let's select that. Insert job parameter, file path. Click out of it, otherwise it will override it. Insert job parameter, target file, and it has all the columns that were propagated to the output stage, output link of the join stage. So we can now just compile this job. And then we can run this job. So we do not need to change any of the parameter values. So we'll just run it. Okay, so all records, all links have turned green. That means it has finished successfully. So we can see that there were some 989 records that we got from the input link from a sales order text file. There were some lookups that were performed. So the product ID was matched and the product names would be propagated further. So there are 989 records coming from the source. When they pass to the aggregator, the output is only 8 records. That means there were only 8 distinct product ID values. So there were only just 8 distinct product values there. So from each aggregator, because the goodbye key column is the same, we have just 8 records coming out of that aggregator. Even from the remove duplicate stage, we have just 8 records coming out because there are 8 distinct values for the product ID. And it has removed all the other duplicate records for the same product ID. It has chosen just one unique record for the product ID. All of them have been joined. We specified an inner join and all the records, none of the records is dropped as expected because all the product IDs are coming from the same input link. Now we look at the data set. You can just do a view data here. Okay. So this is the data that we have. We have the product ID, we have the product name, and these are all distinct product ID values. And then we have the total amount, which is the sum column. So sum of all the line amounts which were present for this product ID have been summed up. So this is the total sales amount for this particular product. So this is something like this. We had the product ID, we have the product name, then this is the total sales amount, which is the sum of the line total. This is the total transactions or the count of the order, sales order for a particular product, and this is the maximum quantity. So the maximum of the value of the order quantity in one single transaction, what was the maximum quantity that was ordered for each of these products. So that is the value we are seeing here. So this is the final format. In the data set, it looks like this. So we have the product ID, product name. This is the count of the orders that we set. This is the sum column, and this is the max column. So all these kind of functions can be performed through the aggregator. Any kind of summary functions can be performed through the aggregator. Now, if we look at the final format, we'll see this is a proper format. Whereas if we look here, all these order quantities and amount quantities, because we defined them as decimals and we gave a specific precision and a scale, they all filled by with zeros. So we can even format these to just consider the relevant part, so it will just show as 5. So there are various functions which are available which we can use to format these quantities and put it in a proper final format that can be inserted into a table. So